Friends, last class we had discussed some of the important types of forest. In that we had discussed there are four types of forest: deciduous forest, evergreen forest, desert vegetations, and we had discussed about scrub forest. And next one point we had discussed about what is mean by forest. So in this class we are discussing next another two important types of forest in India. So in that first one here they given, that is the mountain forest. So what is mean by mountain forest? Here they say the trees and plants that are growing in the place of mountain slope. Trees and plants that are growing in the place of slope of the mountains. So this lake of area for they give a name as a mountain forest. And next one point here they say, so this lake of places we can see in different places of India. So which are the places in we can see? First one here they given Himalayas. After that we can see Nilgiri Hills. And which are the trees we can see in that area? So here they are saying oak, chestnut, ash, beech, pine, cedar, spruce, fir, deodar, walnut. So these like of we can see different types of trees. And another one point, in this mountain forest we cannot see same types of trees and plants in that particular slopes. Based on the altitude for the mountains, we can see there are different types of trees and plants. Because of we already discussed that one, when we are going more and more altitude, we are not getting that much of oxygen. So that's why tree growth and the variety of the plants also differs in mountain forest. So this is one of the important point about mountain forest. So after that, next one is there here, that is mangrove forest. So which area in we can see this one mangrove forest? So here first one they given wet marshy areas, after that river deltas and sea coast vast area. So in that three places in also we can see the mangrove forest we can see in the place of wet areas. After that next one here they say deltas place of rivers, and third one they say coastal lines of India. So in that place in we can see the forest of mangroves. Next one they given, so these like of forest mainly we can see in the part of eastern coastal line. In eastern coastal line we can see the most of the area is covered by mangroves forest. Why? Because of we can see so much of rivers is merged in the part of eastern coastal line, and we can see so much of deltas in eastern coastal line. So that's why we can see the mangrove forest, most of the mangrove forest is located in eastern coastal line. So after that here they are saying which are the trees we can see in that area. So first one here they are saying rhizophora, canes, screw, pipe, palms, sundari. So these like of trees we can see in this area. And we want to know now another one point, that one is we already knowing this one trees mainly growing in the place of water content area, wet area and deltas and sea coastal line. In this area only this lake of mangrove trees is growing, or mangrove forest is growing. That means one of the important structure in that forest, that is the roots. The roots are like they formed in that particular area like a interlock system. So this lake of system in the roots we can see in the place of mangrove forest. So this also one of the important point about mangrove forest. So after the mangrove forest, now we have discussed there are totally 6 types of forest in India. We already knowing these 6 types of forest also we can see in India in different types of places. That means now we are understood the forest is there in India, but we cannot see same type of forest in all over India. We can see there are different types of forest. So now we want to discuss next one point, that means the distribution of forest in India. How much of area is covered by forest, and about the land percentage in how much, and the highest number of forest area located in which state and least area. So these are the points now we want to discuss. So in that first one they given, here first one they saying the distribution of the forest. In first they saying the forest in India totally 7.74 lakh square kilometers. This much of areas we can see forest area in India. Totally 7.74 lakh square kilometers. And next one here they saying in totally we can see there are 23.6% of total geographical area of our country is located by forest. But if you are comparing to our country is the 7th largest country. If you are comparing one country, how much they want to average forest area, how much want to locate it, here they are saying 33.3, but we have only 23.6. Means we not have sufficient forest area in our country. Because of global report already they told that one, based on the structure of the country, in our country they want to have minimum forest area, that is 33%, but we have only 23.6%. So this is one of the important default about in our forest. And next one they say, after that our National Forest Policy Resolution of 1952 based on this one report, and even if you are comparing to the below the world average, so that also we are knowing world average they are saying 29.5%, but we have only 23. First one, the forest policy resolution, on that base we want to have 33, but in our country forest we can see only 23. But global report also, world report also they have provided, on that based average forest area in our country, that is 29%, but we have 23, means we have below forest area in our country. So that's why they are saying. And next one they are saying, in our country we already knowing there are different types of forest we can see, and we have the forest area, but this forest area did not distributed equally in all over the country. Did not distributed equally. So we can say this one, in India forest area is not did not distributed equally. So here they say 60% of forest we can see in the place of, here they say, Himalayas and peninsular hills. So in that place only we can see 60% of forest. One is Himalayas, second one is peninsular hills. Peninsular hill means specially there we can see Eastern Ghats and Western Ghats. So in that place only we can see most of the forest in India, means totally 60% of forest. And remaining 20% of forest we can see in northern plains. In northern great plains, so in that place in we can see 20% of forest. So this way we can say in India the forest is not distributed equally. 60% of forest we can see only north part in only Himalaya range, and southern part in we can see in the place of Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats, especially Peninsula Plateau. And 20% is northern plains. So remaining 20% only we can see in other places. So that's why here they say this forest in India, the forest is not distributed equally. That means in which state in we can see the highest forest? In Madhya Pradesh. In Madhya Pradesh we can see the highest percentage of forest located in the state, that is Madhya Pradesh. Least, so which area or which state in we can see the lowest forest area, means Goa. So this thing we can see the highest located state and lowest located the state. So after that we want to know, next one they say conservation of the forest. Because of when we are discussed about the soil, we are facing so much of problems. Same way here also in forest, this is one of the important content of economic backbone of a country, which one? Forest. Because they give providing so much of resource to peoples or society. So in that purpose, economically forest also one of the useful content in our country. So that's why they say, but nowadays we can see the forest area or the percentage of the forest reducing in recent days. Because of we have only one concept, that is development. So based on development concept, we are destroying the forest. If this locally we are destroying the forest, we cannot live in our country. And our country also did not become ecologically balanced. So these are the problems we are facing. So that's why here they say, not only this one, why we are recent days, why we are decreasing the forest, or why we are cutting the trees So because of, they given some of the reasons. So what was the reasons? First one, they're saying we are expanding our agricultural land. This is one of the important land. And not only this one, we can see there are different types of reasons for deforestation or cutting the trees. So next one here, they say constructions of the roads and railways and irrigation projects, industrialization, urbanization, overgrazing, forest fires. So these are the important causes, important reasons we are destroying the forest. In that based, in the name of these are the reasons we are destroying our forest. And next one they say, but already I told, but we should not destroy the forest because of we need. Without the forest, we cannot live because of already we are discussed that one. We are getting so much of direct and indirect benefits to the forest. We are getting so much of benefits. So that's why we want to secure the forest. That is our duty also. We want to secure the our forest. So here they given. So what is meant by that means conservation of forest. So here they saying definition, the prevention of destructions over exploitations of forest and it is management is called conservation of forest. So here they given definition also. So what is meant by definition they have given? First one they saying, what they damaging the forest, cutting the trees, we want to secure that one. And second one points they say, who are exploiting the forest, that also we want to stop it. Who are exploiting the forest, we want to stop. Plus, who are they cutting the trees, that also we want to secure it. And not only this one, and which one we secure that one forest area, we want to manage it. We want to maintain it, that one particular place. So this only process they give a name as a conservation of forest. We want to secure the deforestation or destructions of the forest and we want to manage that particular area. So this only they give a name as a conservation of forest. So now we want to know what was the method or what was the measures based we can conserve our forest. What was the methods or how we can conserve our forest or secure the forest. So here they given totally 9-10 points. In that based we can secure our forest. So first one they given, control of deforestation. So who are they cutting the trees? We want to stop it. That means we want to regulate some of the rules and laws against that particular act or that particular forest. So this is one of the important point. Second one here they given, restrictions of grazing. We already discussed this one, overgrazing. You want to stop it. We want to limited use of grasses we want to use in our country. So this also one of the important point. And third one, control of forest fires. So nowadays this one is going on. There are so much of numbers forest fires we can see in recent days. So we want to stop it. We want to take prevent about forest fires. Because of we all are knowing in which season we can get this like a forest fire. Before that, we want to do some of the methods or some of the process. So this was one of the important point. After that, prevention of encroachment of on forest. And we want to say to the peoples about the importance of forest. And next one, control of forest insects and disease. And we all are knowing in ecological balance, insects are one of the important content or one of the important insect that one balancing our country or our forest. So that's why we want to secure insects plus disease. Some of the disease also arrived in our forest area, trees or animals, we want to stop and we want to secure it. And next one point they say, sixth one, controlling illegal cutting of trees. So normally nowadays in forest area we can see this like of method. Before the cutting the trees, we want to take permission of forest department. Without the permission of forest department, we should not cut the trees. And next one, scientific cutting of trees. This one, second one, important method. When we are cutting the trees in forest area, we want to cut that one as a scientific method. Is one of the important method. Once again, how we can grow in that particular place in deforestation. So on that based, we want to cut the trees. That only scientific method of cutting the trees. So after that, here they given legislations to check deforestation. And another one, our government always, they want to observe the about of the deforestation. And we want to implement law also. If anybody they cutting the trees, we want to implement serious act or serious punishment for them. So this was one of the important measurement. After that, encouraging afforestation, and you want to say to the peoples, we want to grow a forest. And last one point here, they say creating awareness among the peoples about the importance of forest, and we want to say to the peoples who are cutting the trees or surrounding of our country peoples, we want to say for them, what was the importance of forest? What was the benefits we are getting? These are the matters about we want to give awareness to the people. So these, like, we can see the 10 methods to conserve a forest. And not only these are the methods, we can see our Indian government also, they took some of the measurements or some of the programs to secure a forest plus forest animals, wildlife. So in that purpose for only, our government also, they prepare different types of programs. So in that, we are discussing. In that first one, they given wildlife sanctuaries. So this is one of the important method. In that based, we are securing the animals as well as forest. So what is mean by that? Means wildlife animals, or sorry, wildlife sanctuaries. So here they saying, so wildlife sanctuaries means refer a place that on preventing protection to wildlife. So what is mean by wildlife sanctuaries means that is a place, that is a forest area. So why they built this one wildlife sanctuaries forest area? Because of to protect a wildlife, that one plants or animals, both also to protect for them only we constructed by wildlife sanctuaries. And in that area we are given already one of the important department for we are given already authority. So that department, they are observing that particular wildlife sanctuaries. And one of the important act were implemented in wildlife sanctuary, that is, if should not kill the animals in wildlife sanctuaries area. They prohibited, they implemented the laws to prohibit killing the animals in wildlife sanctuaries. So if they did this like of activities, illegal activities in wildlife sanctuaries, they are getting serious punishment also. So this, like, our government to protect a forest and wildlife, they established by one of the new program, that is wildlife sanctuaries. So next one they given. So in India, we can see there are totally 523 wildlife sanctuaries in India. Totally 523. So here they given some of the important wildlife sanctuaries in India. So first one here they given Annamalai and Madhumalai in Tamil Nadu, Dandeli, Bhadra, Talakaveri, Biar Hills in Karnataka, and Periyar in Kerala, Nagarjun Sagar in Telangana, Nishun Bharatpur and Ratanpur in Rajasthan, and Manasa Assam, Jalatpara in Bengal, West Bengal. So this, like, we can see there are some important wildlife sanctuaries in India. Totally how many are there? Totally 523 wildlife sanctuaries in India. So after that, not only wildlife sanctuaries programs, we can see some other programs also our government is implemented to secure a forest. So next one program here they say, that is the national park. So what is meant by national park? That means, so here they given the extensive area, this is one of the large area. Here they say, in specially we are protected, here they given definition, protected to preserve its natural beauty, wildlife and forest for public recreation and scientific interest is called national park. So here they say, we are protecting an extensive area, means one of the large area. Why we protected that one area? Because of to maintain the natural beauty in that particular area's beauty. And second one they say, to secure wildlife. So which are the wildlife we can see in that area, we want to secure in that purpose. And third one here they say, to this one, public recreation and the purpose of scientific study. For the purpose of scientific study, if for example anyone person are there, they want to get the knowledge about forest area, how animals are living, or forest area, how the trees are growing, and they want to study about the structure of the forest. So in that purpose for only, if anyone forest or government they built, so in that forest for we given name as a national parks. So that means now we are understood. So what is mean by forest? Sorry, what is mean by national parks? So they are saying the area we are prevented, we are secured because of to protect a natural beauty and wildlife, and to public to study a scientific method of a forest. So in that purpose for only we are built by national parks. And next one they say, Here another point they saying, in that place in grazing and agriculture works prohibited by our government or of forest area, sorry, forest department or authority of that particular parks. They prohibited by agriculture work as well as grazing also. So now we want to know how many parks, national parks we can see in India. Totally 29 national parks we can see in India. So in which are the important national parks are there in India? Here they given some of the important parks. One is Kaziranga in Assam, Sundarban in West Bengal, next one Corbett in Uttarakhand, Gir in Gujarat, Kana in MP, Madhya Pradesh, Bandipur, Bannerghatta and Nagarwale in Karnataka, and Sariksha in Rajasthan. Next one here they given Dudhawa in Uttar Pradesh, next one Todaba in Maharashtra. So these are the important national parks we can see in India. Totally 99 national parks. So after this one, next one, another important programs we can see, that is Biosphere Reserve. So this was one of the important programs our central government implemented to secure a forest. So what is meant by Biosphere Reserve? That means, so here the given definition, this is a reserve for special category of protected area of land or coastal environment. So here they say, so what is meant by Biosphere Reserve means, this is one of the important secure place. So why we secure this one place? Here is saying, based on the category, this one is protected area. So why this one is protected area? Because of land and the coastal environment. This both also one of the uniqueness in our culture, in our tradition. And they're giving so much of contribution to our ecological balance, or in our country, or in our environment, or in our climate condition. So in that purpose only, we have secured some of the place. So in that place for given name as a Biosphere Reserve. This is one of the protected area, or a land or a coastal environment. We are secure because of, we are getting so much of benefits in that particular area. So one of the important point I will say about the Western Ghats. This is also one of the important Biosphere Reserve in India. So why we secure this one? Because of, we are getting the monsoon season. One of the important reason, that is Western Ghats. So in that purpose only, we are securing the Western Ghats. And another one, we can see the Himalaya range. This was one of the important Biosphere Reserve. So why we given that like a special post, a special stage for that particular place, Himalaya range? Because of they protecting against of enemies, and they protecting the cold winds coming in the side of Siberia or Central Asia. So in that purpose only, we are given special interest about that particular area. So this like of area for, we are given name as a Biosphere Reserve. And next one here they say, when we are discussing about in this point about Biosphere Reserve, we can see the government, they give us special interest to on that particular area's peoples. Because of in that particular area's traditions or practice, that is very unique. We cannot get that like of tradition or practice in any other caste or any other religion. So this like of practice we can see in that Biosphere Reserve serious peoples. And next one here they given, and not only this one, the main object is why the government is established this like of Biosphere Reserves, because of first one they given, first one conservation, to protect that one area. And second one they are saying to research, they want any person or they want to study about that area. So in that purpose, and education and local involvement, and for the education purpose, and they want to involve the local peoples, and they want to secure the forest. So in that purpose for only, they established by Biosphere Reserves. So these like, we can see the government, our Indian government, they established by different types of programs or different types of act or measurements to control our forest and wildlife. So these are the important points about Indian forest resource. So next class we can discuss about next topic. Okay.